So added clips can be selected and rearranged in the project timeline by dragging and dropping them. For example, if we wanted to move this clip, we can just drag it over, and you see there is a green vertical line where we want to add it, and when we release it, it drops it into that new location. Or we can put it back to where it was originally. To modify the video or audio properties of a clip, you will need to open the Media Inspector. Highlight the clip that you wish to modify and select the Media Inspector button. And then by looking under Clip, Video, or Audio, we can change those specific properties. By selecting the clip, we can change the duration of the clip here. We can also add a special video effect, and that can be previewed here. Similarly, an audio effect. We can change the speed, but that requires converting the entire clip, and we can do some other things to stabilize the motion if it is if your video is unsteady. By selecting a video, we can make finer adjustments to the image. We can change the exposure, the brightness, contrast, saturation. We can also change the white point by selecting a light colored area or gray area in the image, and everything will be adjusted to that. Selecting audio, we can change the volume of the clip by moving the scroll bar. If there are two audio files, you can reduce the volume of one track relative to another by selecting ducking, and then you can select the percentage by which that secondary file is the volume is lowered. The audio can be made to fade in and fade out at the beginning and the end of the clip, and you can do some other things as well. By selecting normalize, you can adjust the clip volume to optimal listening levels by bringing the loudest part of the selected clip to maximum listening level without distortion, and other parts are adjusted accordingly. And then we select done when we're finished. Now let's look at how to add other media to our movie project. We can add still images by selecting the photo browser here and then selecting and dragging the image that we wish to add over into our timeline and drop it. And you'll see that automatically the default duration for that image is going to be 4 seconds. If we want to change that, then we open up the inspector for clip adjustments and we can change the duration, for example, to 6 seconds by retyping and then select done. And now that image, when we play it, will play for 6 seconds. We can also make video adjustments as we did for the video footage, changing exposure, brightness, contrast, and so forth. And we can adjust the white point by selecting a white or gray area in the image, and that adjustment will be made. Another change that we might want to make is to crop the image. We can actually make the image fit into the entire viewer window. We can crop it to a different size by readjusting the size of the green frame, or we can add a Ken Burns effect by changing the position and size of the start frame, and then we do the same thing for the end frame. And the arrow is going to show you the direction of movement that is being added with the Ken Burns effect. And when we select done, now we can go back, and when we hit the space bar to play, you see that the image expands and tracks to the upper left. In the next part, we'll look at how to add other media to a movie project.